Cursor released a visual editor. So they're going all in on vibe coding, or at least they want to capture a part of that cake too and move away from the focus on assisting developers and instead move into that direction of Lovable, V0, and all those other vibe coding platforms. At least that were my very initial thoughts when I read that announcement. And I have very mixed feelings about this new feature. I spent some time with it, did some research, so let me share those thoughts and feelings and show you what it is and what it's maybe not. So yesterday, they announced this visual editor for the Cursor browser, and in case you didn't know, Cursor already had a browser where you could preview your website. Here I have a very simple HTML, CSS website, not even using a framework here, but of course the idea is that you can review any kind of website here in that browser. Now, even before the visual editor thing, you could select elements here and then they would be inserted here as context into your chat, and you could ask questions or request changes like give it a blue background. So you could already do that. Now, however, that changes. Now you can open this inspector here and you can actively change this page in this Cursor browser. So if I select this item by simply clicking on it, I can drag and drop it, and it's a bit weird still, but I can, for example, drop it here, and now it's the second item instead of the first item, which it was before. Now, what's interesting is that this is only a visual change here in that browser. So if I open the respective HTML file, there my popover API link, which I dragged and dropped, is still the first in that grid in front of the container queries link, which is not in line with what I see here in the browser. So the code did not update, just the UI. Now I can press this apply button here or undo if I want to revert this change, but if I press apply, then this change description gets inserted here into my context and it automatically kicks off the process of changing it. And here what we have in the end is a description of what changed, so the DOM order, and the Cursor agent then goes ahead and makes that edit in my HTML file, and in this case moves the container queries entry in front of the popover API entry. And before you go to the comment section, I'm not done yet. I know how stupid this example is, because spending tokens, spending money in the end on this change instead of just changing it manually in HTML makes absolutely no sense. And as I mentioned, I have some thoughts about this feature, and many of those thoughts are indeed about which problem does this solve exactly that I couldn't solve more efficiently as a developer. And I'll get back to that, hold that thought. I'm just showing you how that feature works. That is kind of the idea. You can change things, you see a preview, you can then apply that, and then the agent will get started and will implement that change. So that is the feature. As I mentioned, my initial thoughts were, okay, this is the vibe coding move. They are clearly now trying to target an audience that doesn't really want to go into the code, that can't go into the code, and that instead just wants to change things visually. And if you're like me, which means old, that might sound familiar, because back when I was young, we had Dreamweaver. Not sure if you know it. I think it still exists, to be honest, but Dreamweaver was one of the first, let's call it IDEs, I had when I got started with web development and development in general around the 2000s. It was an editor, here's a nice screenshot, that would allow you to basically review your website and drag and drop elements in there and make changes here through an inspector. And behind the scenes, it would update the HTML and CSS code. Now, Dreamweaver obviously did not do that with AI agents, but simply by updating the HTML and CSS code. If you gave something a red color, it would go into the CSS or HTML code and simply change the style, the color, to red. That was Dreamweaver. Now, just like in Dreamweaver back then, this visual editor does not just allow you to select elements and drag them around, it also allows you to configure them here. So you got this inspector, right? And in there, you can take a look at the CSS that's actually applied to those elements, and you can change that CSS if you want to. And you can also go to this design tab here and in there change a bunch of things about the design. So you got different options here for changing the flow. Okay, nothing is having an effect here on this element. Let's maybe select this grid. Here you see with that I can easily change my grid and preview different versions. And of course, not just preview them, but if I'm happy with this approach, I could click apply and cursor would go ahead and apply those changes in code so that they become permanent. And there are a bunch of other options for changing colors, fonts, and all that fun stuff. A second analogy I had was a more modern tool, which is Storybook. A storybook, in case you don't know it, is essentially a tool that you can use for building and testing components. So if you're working on a big React app, you might have a lot of UI components and also, in general, components in there, which you might want to build and test in isolation. You especially also might want to test some niche use cases. So you could use a tool like Storybook for that. And that also allows you to preview your components and kind of configure them in the UI. You could set some different props values to preview how they change. It's not really a tool for visually working on your source code, though. It's more about testing and testing those components and testing different configuration states. That's Storybook. I'm bringing that up because one feature this visual editor also has only becomes visible if you're in React apps, or I think in general, apps that use components. Not sure, definitely in React apps. So here I got a React app, the Build My Graphic website I built, buildmygraphic.com, which is live, which you can use to generate infographics on a vast amount of presets and configuration options. And let's say there I'm working on a new feature and I want to have a guides section or whatever, doesn't matter. And since it's a React app, I'm obviously working with components. So this is a component. My image here is actually a component. If you do select a component, then in this inspector, at the very bottom, you can not just change some attributes, but you can also configure that component. You got this properties area here. Let me zoom out a bit. And then these are all the props that I could set here. And I could dynamically try out different configurations to preview that. Now, this is not so much about changing anything in your code. This is more really about testing different configurations and seeing live previews, which is important because that really seems to be the direction the Cursor team wants to move into here. It really looks, to me at least, as if this visual editor is meant as a tool that allows people that don't really want to go into code or can't go into code to build the entire website. So to visually change it, to adjust it as they need, and of course still also write regular prompts to request bigger changes or changes that are not mostly visual, but to also test different configurations so that the visual editor really looks like a tool that's meant to become a core part of Cursor, at least for people that don't want to code. It looks like it's an idea that wants to gather all these people that want to build websites, but that can't in a traditional way, at least. You could also say that maybe Cursor wants to attack tools like Figma, where you design applications, you don't get code out of that, you design them, and then traditionally you would have taken that design and handed it off to some developer. Though, of course, it's worth noting that we already have tools like Framer, which allow you to design and convert that design to code right now. You don't need Cursor or Lovable. You could just use Framer for that. Or you could use a visual editor built into Vix. We already have all these no-code tools. Still, it looks like Cursor kind of also wants to move into that direction too and grab a part of that pie. The problem I see is just Cursor is a tool which I think you wouldn't really know about or even consider using If you don't have any technical skills, if you know absolutely nothing about writing code, it's also quite expensive, at least if you want to get a decent amount of usage out of it. And that usage part is important because if you have to use the AI agent for every single tiny change, if I reorder something, and in order to apply that change, I have to burn tokens and ask the AI, that's not very efficient and it's definitely not cheap over time. Now, of course, this is the initial version of that editor. I think it's perfectly possible that future iterations will apply certain changes without AI immediately in the code, just as Dreamweaver did. But right now, it's all AI, and that, of course, is not very efficient. Still, could be a good option if you really are not confident diving into the code. But then again, the question is if that's a target audience that is about to use Cursor. If other no-code tools like Framer or Vix or solutions like Lovable are not more interesting to that audience. I don't know. I am not that audience. Now, that brings me to me and probably also you. What about us? Is this a feature that's interesting for me? Will I use it? I'll be honest, I don't see a good use case for me right now. I am using AI for writing code, as you know, and no, I'm not vibe coding, I'm not doing everything with it, but I'm using it as an assistant and I find it very helpful for that. I also, of course, use it for UI development, like telling Cursor to build me a grid of certain items, and I think you can rapidly prototype by using Cursor or other tools for AI, for UI development. But this feature specifically, where I can change individual parts of the UI, I typically just do those changes myself, because I don't really see an advantage of using Cursor for that. Sure, if I wanted a bigger change here, if I wanted to make sure that, let's say, I don't have a grid or a list of items here, but instead a carousel of items where I can like swipe through those items, that is something I might ask Cursor to build, but that's not something I can build here with this visual editor. Here I can just change individual properties, colors, drag things around, and I don't really need AI for that. Also, maybe something you didn't know, if you really want that feedback loop where you can change stuff, where you can change colors maybe and have that apply to your code because you don't want to like do it in code and go back to the browser to preview the changes, but you want to change it visually, you can already do that totally without AI with Chrome DevTools. It's a feature I don't think many people know, but if you have your page open in the Chrome DevTools, under sources, you can add a workspace. Let me actually remove that workspace here. So you can add a workspace. And what you do is you select your project folder. So in my case, this one here. Give Chrome the permissions to read and manage that workspace. And once you do that, if you're on this Elements tab and you select, let's say, one of these items, and you decide that you want to tweak those styles, you could, of course, always do that here. I hope you knew that. You can change the color. Let's say I want to have this color because there's not enough purple on this page. So I can change that here. This is not changed back to my project, of course. But since I added this here, I actually can just save this file. And now it will have been added. If I now reload, this is still active. And if I take a look at my code here, this is active here too. So you could already have that kind of visual editor by just using the Chrome DevTools. Obviously, I'm totally aware this is not a feature you'll use if you don't know anything about writing code. It's way too scary and weird and whatever. But you can already do that if you want to. If you want these tiny changes, if you want to be able to live preview them and then just save them back, you can do that totally without AI and therefore way more cost effective. And therefore, long story short, what are your thoughts on this? My thoughts really are that this is a feature that may be helpful to a certain audience, but an audience that's definitely not me. I think right now it's also way too limited in what you can do any greater UI changes. As mentioned, if I wanted to add a carousel there, I still would have to write a regular prompt. There is no visual way of doing that. But I definitely see a future where this maybe ships with a component library built in, just like the good old Dreamweaver, where you can then drag and drop a carousel into your page and configure that. I definitely see that future, because clearly the cursor team experiments a lot, which is good, and clearly it's an interesting market to capture or to be part of if you can not just cater to developers who know how to write code, but if you can also reach an audience of designers that want to build websites that maybe know something about code, but not enough to feel confident going into the code themselves. That's definitely an interesting audience, and I imagine, and that is what Cursor seems to take a shot at. Maybe there also are use cases I'm totally missing, and it could be totally awesome for me, but right now, I don't feel like it is.